What's up, HL fam? So this morning I am on my way to my consult to further enhance my smile. I told you guys I have a lot of things that I am looking to get done. I'm gonna see what the doctor recommends. But I am looking to possibly get, I think it's called like a gingivectomy. Which is removing some of my gums from the top, kind of lasering them back a bit, because my smile is very gummy. So I'm gonna look into that, see what he recommends on that. My front two teeth, they need to be elongated just a tad bit, like millimeters, very, very little amount, because they're kind of short. Sorry guys, I'm kind of talking kind of weird because of my retainers, if you can hear how I'm talking. So yeah, I want to elongate my front two teeth just a teeny eensy weensy bit. And then one of my front two teeth, I think it's the left one, it has the slightest little curve in it. So my orthodontist couldn't close my gap because of that reason. So I'm going to see if they can shave down that tooth and then use some type of, I don't know, like some type of something to add some like fake tooth material, I guess, to the insides of my teeth to close it up a bit. And then the last thing that I'm looking to get done is possibly, I definitely need like a veneer or a bonding on my side two teeth. But I'm not quite sure if they just, instead of like all the things that I talked about for my front two teeth, if they just want to put a veneer or bonding on my front two teeth. So there is a lot of, definitely a lot of options when it comes to like the things that I want to get done for my teeth. So we will definitely see what the doctor says. I'm really excited. My, especially like my side two teeth, that is something that I've wanted to do pretty much all of my adult life. Like I never really noticed it, or I guess it never really bothered me until I was in college. So yeah, I'm really excited to see what they have to say. Not quite sure how much I will be able to record in the appointment, but of course, if I can, you know, I'll record as much as I possibly can. Oh hell no. y'all remember that thing? They'd be like, oh hell no, uh-oh. That's literally how I'm feeling right now. Okay, so I wasn't able to record. It was kind of like weird. It was only like me and the doctor, so I didn't want to be like all up in his face with the camera. But first and foremost, okay, I'm sitting there and my doctor comes in. She's young, she's black, okay, and she got cornrows going straight to the back. I was like, yes sis. She must have been like, she introduced herself as doctor, but I guess she was, maybe it was like a residency, or I don't know, not a residency because I think that's when you're still in school, but she was like an intern, or that's the wrong word to use for a doctor, but that's essentially what she was doing. But yeah, she talked to me first and then the other doctor came in. So basically to go over everything we discussed, okay, whitening is no problem, boom, that's an easy fix. He said he does not recommend me doing the gingivectomy, which is removing some of the gum. He said for so many different reasons. One, in your gums is where your bones live. You have bones in your gum, you also have nerves in your gum. So when you're cutting into that, you run the risk of exposing nerves, of loosening your teeth. You don't want to like recede your gums for, you know, for no reason, basically. He said he wouldn't touch that whatsoever. So that is out. He did say he recommends to get six veneers going straight across from canine to canine, because one, you want the spacing, like you can't just add two teeth on the side, which is what I thought they could do. You want to make sure that the spacing is even across the board. You also want to make sure that the teeth are uniform across the board and all look the same. So he wouldn't do just the front four. He would definitely recommend doing the front six. So y'all hold on to your seats. So they also recommended, yes, the veneer, not the veneer. Did they recommend the veneers? Yeah, yes, no, the crowns. Crowns is what they recommended, not veneers. And so the total is basically $8,000, okay? And so I definitely thought it was gonna be pricey, just maybe not this costly. So what? So here are my options. Here's what I'm thinking, right? Because I'm definitely not paying $8,000. It's absolutely a no. Well, not at this time in my life, like right now, before, you know, I just got too much going on right now that I'm not going to kick out $8,000 for this. So here's what I'm thinking. So before the insurance and the discounts and stuff like that, it was actually almost $12,000. And then my insurance kicked in a little bit and got it down to almost $8,000. So a little less than $8,000. So I'm thinking that I am going to wait until open enrollment, which is, I think, in like March, I think, or maybe February. Wait until open enrollment and look at other options for dental care that will increase my my maximum, because my maximum right now is $1,500. Like, they gave me a lot of discounts, but my insurance is really only covering $1,500, which is nothing on a $12,000 bill, okay? I am going to enroll in an HSA and or FSA plan so that they can pay for it. I mean, we're paying for it still, but they will give you the money up front, and that way it will also lower our taxable income. So that's also good. So yeah, I'm gonna just look into a bunch of different options during open enrollment to see if they can cover more of this bill, because I'm definitely not kicking out $8,000. Oh, but I'm glad that I have this paperwork. I'm gonna sit down and talk to Henry about it when I get home. But since Anaya is asleep and Henry told me to, and I quote, enjoy myself, I'm gonna go to Home Goods really quick. They got some Christmas wreaths up.
Let's go to the ocean. Yeah, let's go outside. We can hang out on the beach without freezing.
Oh my gosh, y'all, this is the cutest thing. It's a little bench. I would love to put this in Anaya's room. Oh my goodness, look how cute this is.
Hey guys, so it's the next day and we are at the pediatrician. We just finished up with our visit. This was Anaya's 9-month checkup, even though she's going to be 10 months next week. It just always happens like that with the scheduling. But yeah, she did amazing. I love seeing our doctor. She is just so wonderful. And so she just was really happy to see Anaya and to see her progress and like see her teeth and stuff like that. It was really nice. But yeah, so every time I'm here, she always gives me Similac. But this time, sit back, mamas. Sit back, mamas. What are you doing? She's trying to see the camera. What are you doing? She just got her shots and she was crying, so I'm feeding her. Hey, mama. Hey, baby. Good job. But this time, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. She gave me 6 boxes of Similac. So I don't even, mommy, what are you doing? So my plan was after this to go to Target, since I told you guys they have Similac for 25% off. But now that she gave me all this, it's like, should I even do it? So I might as well, like, even if I can get one for free, I might as well, like, just pick it up, because I'm definitely going to need it for at least the next few months.
Hi, mommy. Hi, floral baby. Look at her, y'all. This is the cutest little onesie that we got from Old Navy. Say hi. So I got the Starbucks. I got a breakfast sandwich.
And a venti cup, dirty chai.
Thank you.
Welcome, lovely. Have a great day.
You too. We just got back from Target and Trader Joe's, and I slipped into the most comfy clothes. I got on this big t-shirt and sweatpants, because I just feel like we've been out all morning. It's like 12:30. We left the house at 8:30. So I'm gonna show you guys what I got from Trader Joe's. This is the least amount of items I have ever gotten from Trader Joe's. All right, first things first, I got some brioche bread, my favorite, so that we can have some French toast. Do you guys know that the pumpkin brioche is already out of season? I was so sad. I was looking for it and she was like, it's already out of season. And I'm like, what? The season just started. And she was saying that basically when new products come about, they can come in for days, they can come in for weeks, and then they're just like snatched off the shelves, and Trader Joe's looks at how well they did in sales, and then maybe the following year it'll let Trader Joe's know how much to restock for the year after. So that was frustrating because that was part of the reason that I went all the way down there. And then I got two little mini pumpkins. I was telling you guys in the last vlog when we went to the pumpkin patch that I didn't get a chance to get it, and somebody commented and said that they were at Trader Joe's and I found them. So such cute little pumpkins. And then I got some bananas to go in Anaya's yogurt. And it's so funny because I did all that trying to find the best yogurt for Anaya, and then when I took it to the pediatrician this morning, she's like, oh yeah, she can have like regular yogurt and things that have whole milk in it, but you can't just like flat out give her a cup of whole milk to drink. But I'm still gonna give her the regular yogurt that I've been giving her, because I was telling you guys it's just too much sugar in the other one. So even though it doesn't have to be coconut milk, I still wanted it unsweetened. And then I got some shaved Brussels sprouts. You guys know this is also one of my favorites. Just love Brussels sprouts. And then the last thing I got was this pumpkin pie spice. I figured it would come in handy with the holidays coming up and, you know, just the season that we're in right now. But I especially got it because I thought I was going to get the pumpkin brioche. So I was going to make pumpkin French toast. And I still might make like pumpkin spice French toast. I just think it would have been even better on the pumpkin brioche. So that's all I got. And then from Target, I got another thing of Similac, and then I showed you guys all of the Similac that our pediatrician got us. So I'm about to put this away and make some French toast for breakfast / lunch. So we will talk to you guys in a bit. Thank you.